गुड इवनिंग गाइस,
या गुड इवनिंग ऑल।
होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एंड हेल्दी। ओके जितेश, कैन वी स्टार्ट?
या लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड मैन।
ओके, सो टुडेस ट्रेनिंग सेशन इज बेसिकली अबाउट कंटेंट मार्केटिंग एंड स्ट्रेटजीज फॉर राइटिंग किलिंग आर्टिकल्स। सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी मेंशन्ड यू, राइट?
Yeah.
Okay. Then let's start. We have already 48 participants, so I think it is a good count to start. So let's begin. So here is a quick introduction about the training session. In this training session, you are going to learn about content marketing introduction and the strategy for writing killing articles. So what does actually content marketing mean? Content marketing is the intersection of advertising and publishing. So what is it? What is the intersection of advertising and publishing? It is a huge doubt for any for all of you. So let me quickly explain it with some examples. So firstly, let me explain with an example of newspaper. Basically, we all read newspapers and we also see some ads, some ad blocks in the newspapers. So a published newspaper has some advertising. It is the content marketing, the intersection of publishing and advertising. Did you got the point? If yes, please comment yes in the comment section. And also I will tell you one more example. The other example is quite simple. If you watch movies or any ads, the actors starts wearing any shoe brands or any brands like t-shirts, any branded t-shirts or any branded pants, which usually resemble some brands and which usually promote some brand. It is nothing but the actor is publishing some content in the form of advertising, and this is known as the intersection of advertising, and we call it content marketing. Did you got the point? If yes, please comment yes in the comment section. Great guys, I am getting good responses. So let's move on to the next slide. So Jitesh, can you please explain me an example?
Yeah, now I'm going to give you the quick review about what Vivek had said about content marketing in a beautiful example of fishing hook. Yes, there is a fishing stick and a fishing hook that you can observe on the screen now, and if you were about to give that fishing hook or fishing stick to sell it, how would you sell it? That's my question to you, and I will give a quick answer to it. Now let's imagine two scenarios, and please take down the notes, and this is important topic. Take two scenarios. In scenario one, you are just marketing it by advertising it by using banners, and you have just sticked a wall poster at the place where public is present. And let's take some 100 people have watched your ad of fishing hook. I think two people know how to fish. So maximum rate, 2% conversion rate will be there for your product, so that they know how to perform fishing, so they will buy your fishing hook. And remaining 98 members will not show interest to buy your fishing hook because that's not needed for them. And let's take scenario two. In this scenario, we are going to educate all, there are 100 prospects. We are going to educate 100 prospects how to fish, means we are going to teach them how to fish or how to do fishing, and we are going to explain some benefits. We are going to tell in your weekends, if you fish, it's a great natural thing that you're going to do in your weekends. Like that, we are going to explain some benefits about the fishing hook and fishing stick. And if you start advertising about that, in 100, I don't say 90%, but 40 to 50 conversion rate will be there, because you are explaining the benefits and you are teaching them, and then you're selling it. Here is the loop where you are explaining them the benefits, so that they are going to buy your fishing product. So here the content is, you are explaining them. So this is the scenario where you will get the difference by advertising the product by wall posters and advertising the product by explaining them. I think this is the best example which defines the content marketing. Yeah,
hey guys. Hey guys, it's a nice explanation about the content marketing. But before that, I forgot about a point that take notes because this is a huge content and this training will be a little bit confusing to you. So as Jitesh explained about an example, I will conclude content marketing in a single sentence. That is, content marketing is, note down this point, content marketing is teaching how to fish and selling fishing hooks. Note down this point, teaching about fishing and selling fishing hooks. This is the ultimate sentence for content marketing. Please note down these points, guys. So let's jump on to the next slide. So here is the ultimate formula for content marketing, and I want Jitesh to explain about it.
Yes, ultimate formula of content marketing.
Can you repeat the point?
Yeah, Vivek, repeat the point again.
So, the ultimate sentence for content marketing is teaching fishing and selling fishing hooks. Content marketing is equal to teaching fishing and selling fishing hooks.
Yeah. Great. Ultimate formula of content marketing, great content. If you are going to give you the great content to the audience, if you are going to give the great content, then you are going to grab more number of audience. If more number of audience were in your hand, you are going to advertise your product. So ultimately your product is going to be sold. And if poor content, less audience. If less audience, there is no second point. So no audience, so no advertising. Again, if you have the great content, you are going to attract more number of audience. If you have more number of audience, you are going to advertise your product and you are going to sell it. If you have poor content, so no audience, so no advertising, so no selling. So this is the formula of content marketing. And the PPT will be shared to you, don't worry. And take down some notes.
So as Jitesh told about the content marketing formula, so where to start and when to start and how to start, these are the usual doubts many of them get. So here is the answer for that. Social media. And I am going to tell you the power of social media and what does actually media means. Look these sentence very carefully, because media is anything that aggregates the attention of definable market segment into a specific location at a predictable time. Let me summarize it. Like, media is attracting or aggregating people's attention to a specific location at a predictable time. This is called as media. It might either be social media or news media or anything, but it aggregates and attracts the attention of the people of a specific market segment into a specific location at a predictable time. It is known as media. Did you got the point? If yes, please yes in the comment section. Wow, great responses, guys. So let's move on to the next slide. So here is the basic technology you needed for content marketing. Remember one point, guys. Generally, we are suggesting you these tools and technologies for creating some awesome content. But these tools are not mandatory for most of them, but some of the tools are definitely needed for creating content. So let's quickly review all the tools and technologies you really needed for creating some awesome content, guys. So first, let's go with the content management system. What does actually content management system means? So when you host a website, you definitely need a blog to get some traffic. So to manage all those content in the blog, we need a system or a builder that is known as WordPress. And the best known CMS in the world is WordPress. So definitely we are going to prefer you to use WordPress because it is the best CMS in the world. And here is the email service provided. What do you mean by email service provided? And why do we need email service provided means? Email marketing is usually nothing but outreaching to your audience and to your prospects. So that's why we definitely need email service provided. And we suggest you a paid tool. It is ActiveCampaign. And ActiveCampaign is usually paid, but it works brilliantly when you use for email marketing outreach. And we suggest you a free tool of 2,000 subscribers for completely free, and it is MailChimp. We can mail up to 2,000 subscribers for completely free in MailChimp. So there is a paid tool. So let's move to the next slide. Here is a microphone. And why do we need microphones? Means microphones are very crucial in creating content for podcast and for blog means YouTube videos, most of them knows. So definitely you need a nice microphone or a brilliantly working microphone to record your voice for podcasts and for blogs. So definitely we suggest you to buy a microphone. And definitely here is you need a video camera for recording all your training sessions or all your content for doing content marketing. And Jitesh, you may continue.
Yeah. Now coming to webinar softwares. Even webinar softwares is a platform where we can show our content to the people. Now we are using Zoom to outreach our content to you people. And here are some examples where these are some examples. Go to webinar, Cisco Webs, and all these things. And if you are a digital marketer and if you want to outreach your source, you need a webinar software so that you can reach the people all over the world in the situations where you can't meet the people. And next slide, coming to the next one. Image editing. Yes. I think more than the text, image works. If you have a blog and instead you start your title or start your paragraph with a text, if you place an image which looks quite interesting, and then if you provide a text, the audience who is reading your blog may first see your image and next read your text. So I prefer image more than a text. So using these tools like Photoshop, Lightroom, Canva, PixelArt, we can create an awesome pictures so that you can grab audience authority to your content. And this is one of the platforms we suggest you to use. And next, video editing softwares. Yeah. For creating amazing videos, and if you are going to open a vlog in YouTube channels, definitely you should have a great content so that you can make people to sustain in your page for minutes and minutes. Video editing or creating content using videos is more suggestible than text and images, because people get connected to your content for minutes, at least seconds. So that video, providing content in the form of video is more preferable than text and image, but I'm not telling that images are not will not work, but video is better. And these are the softwares where you can edit your videos. And I think these three are paid: Filmora, Adobe Premiere Pro.
I think it might be your network interruption.
I think all the audience are audible with me.
Yes, please comment yes in the comment session.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. These three, yes, you're audible. These three video softwares are best. And the last one is Final Cut Pro, and this is for Mac, and this Adobe Premiere Pro and Filmora for Windows. And next. Screen capture softwares. This usage of screen capture software is record your screen. And why to record your screen? What's the use? And some of the people in your class were not able to get the recording, so that you can record it, and it's the content, so that you can place the screen recordings in your YouTube channel, or you can grow your channel, and that's the content. So Camtasia Studio 9, we choose this as the best screen capture software.
So guys, here is the actual topic you are waiting for, because strategies are very crucial in writing killing articles. And we are going to suggest you 9 tips to convert your audience by using your articles. So let's jump on to the first tip.
And please take the notes. These 9 tips are very important to include in your article.
Yeah, guys, definitely take notes, because these 9 tips are very crucial. And so here is the first tip. It is be original. Be original means what? When your audience should connect with you only when you are original, because you should be original by providing your true experiences, and the situations you have even experimented once. You should provide a content that is really original, and that is you have already experimented or experienced. So definitely the content will be original, and definitely the audience will be connected to you as the content is very original. So diving to the next tip, here is the tip 2, and it is producing actionable content. So what do you mean by actionable content? Means if you consider Wikipedia just gives informations. That's it. Wikipedia doesn't suggest you to redirect or convert, or they doesn't give you any actions to do after reading their information. So definitely, as a content marketer and as a digital marketer, we should provide actionable content where we can push the audience after engaging all your content. We should push the audience to a certain sale or to a certain conversion. That is known as producing actionable content. So let's move on to the next tip. So publish accurate information. Definitely guys, keep this in mind. We can provide content, but that should be very true and very accurate. You should also include statistics, accurate informations, and to build credibility, you should definitely use statistics and accurate informations and proof to your content, so that the audience can engage and also build trust and credibility for you and for your business. Here is the tip 4. Tell a story. Everyone has very familiar with the storytelling. So why should we include a story in the content? Means when the reader actually hooked to your headline, he should engage from starting to ending of the content through your content, so that it should not be boring, right? So definitely include a story which keeps the audience engaging from starting to ending of your content. So that's the reason we should tell a story in our content. Moving on to the tip 5, and tip 5 will be explained by Jitesh.
Yeah, Vivek. And the tip 5 is make sure your audience think about your content. But why? First, suppose you are reading a ad or a Google ad. If you open Google Chrome, now we are able to see some ads down the search bar. In that, out of 10, minimum 8 of the ads will remain or last in your mind for one day, because since they are in trending, they will be shown in your AdSense in top positions. And so that's the content is viral. So when you are writing your article, make a habit of reading it once again and once again. If you write two lines, read it from first again and think that whether this content is making the audience to think about it, or it should last at least for 2 days. Your content that you are providing to your audience should last in their mind at least for 2 days, so that they will visit your website again and again. So this is one of the tip you have to keep in your mind while you are writing your article. Coming to the next tip, and the tip 6 is use visuals. As I already explained that images work better than text. Suppose we are writing a 1,000-word article. In 1,000-word articles, the average visuals we can use are 5 to 10. In this ratio, you can divide it of how many visuals we have to use while writing your article. In order to make audience to last in your content, so to not make him bored, we have to insert some images which are related to our content. So use visuals. These works. And tip 7. And the tip 7 is master your headline. Yes. Master your headline in the sense, in an article, we can't even, we cannot directly start it. So we have to write an article. If it is on cooking, if we start like this, top 5 tips you have to try so that your kitchen is the tastiest restaurant ever. So if you put a heading like this, audience who are reading your heading will definitely read your content. So to grab the audience into your content, your headline should be of exclamatory or any question. Okay, use this tips tip to grab audience into your introduction. And next, tip 8. Hook readers into your introduction. Yes. As your heading is already a hook, compulsory they will expect something in your introduction. See, if your headline is quite interesting, they will be reading your introduction with the same expectation, so that your introduction should be the bright spot of your content. Of our content or article, your introduction should be the bright spot. So while writing the introduction, keep in mind that audience are going to read your introduction with a high expectation, as you have what you have mentioned in your heading. So your introduction should be the bright spot. And the last but not least, tip 9, mix up your content. Okay, this is a practice that you have to make while writing your article. See, now you don't know how to start an article. Now what you should do, just visit the websites where already other people are writing. Just see how they are writing, steal the ideas but not the content. Again guys, I'm telling you, just steal the ideas, how they are performing, how they are using the words, how they are using the copies to grab audience into their website. Steal those ideas, but do not copy them. Mix them with your talent. Make a new type of conversion so that when audience reading your content, they should not get bored. And steal only the ideas, but not the content. Content should be of own. Just keep it in your mind. And these are the 9 tips. And following all those 9 tips as a checklist is quite confusing. Yes, guys. Even though you have written all these 9 tips in your notes now, you don't know how to insert them in this. We are going to explain now on VMarketing Brothers Decoded a new formula where you can insert all these 9 tips and make your article creative and highly engaging. And these tips, on these the next coming formula will be explained by Vivek, so that your 9 tips will not be lost. Yeah, Vivek.
Hey guys, definitely after going through all the 9 tips, you might be some confusing and how to actually use those tips to write an engaging content. So we have decoded a formula for you, and even we use for our own content. So I think this formula will definitely be useful for you. So let's decode it. What do you mean by 4 P's? 4 P's are actually promise, picture, proof, and push. So what do you mean by first P, promise? So what is a promise, and how can a promise can include in our content, and where we can include that? Promise can be included in headlines and our introductions, where we can hook the reader's attention. A promise can either be a huge promise, like lose your weight in just 15 days. It is a big promise, right? If someone wants to lose their weight, or someone looking for a dating plan, definitely this promise can grab their attention, right? So definitely include promises in your headlines and in your introductions. So moving on to the next P. It is the second P, and it is picture. So what do you mean by picture? As I told you, tell a story to engage them from starting to ending of your content. So second P is picture. Definitely include a story in your body of the content. Tell them a story. As I told you, the headline of lose your weight in 15 days is a headline, and the introduction is elevated on those promises. And after in the body, I have shared my experience, which elevates a story, and even the reader imagines himself as if he follow the diet plan, or if he follow the process which I have used to lose the weight. Definitely he gonna engage from starting to ending of the content. So definitely include a picture in your body. Moving on to the next P, it is proof. Include a proof to build credibility and trust. In businesses, or even in digital marketing and content marketing, definitely trust and credibility plays a key role to convert the prospects. So definitely include proofs in your content. At the end of the content, definitely include proofs like statistics, accurate informations, and the many proofs like testimonials. Even include testimonials to build some trust. So this is the third P. And moving to the next P, it is push. As I told you, always produce actionable content. Push means call to actions. Always include call to actions in the ending of the content. After completely engaging through your content, at the end the reader should convert. Either it may be a subscriber or maybe a customer. A call to action may even include like subscribe to our channel and please buy this product to lose your weight. So it is also a call to action. So the push or call to action either may be subscribing or converting or becoming a customer. So always include a push. So here are the 4 P's. So note it down: promise, picture, proof, and push. Remember these 4 P's. Definitely your content is going to be highly engaging and highly converting. So don't forget the 4 P's, and definitely we are proud to share with these formula with you. And taking over to Jitesh.
Yeah. And the doubt you might be having in your brains is how to apply them. Yes, you have learned 4 P's and 9 tips, and these all should be mixed up and should be framed in a particular manner so that your article can be ranked in Google. Yes, to rank in Google, the minimum weight of the article should be 1,000 words. Remember this: to rank in Google, the article that you are going to write should be of minimum 1,000 words or maximum 1,000 words. 1,000 words is minimum. Yeah. Next slide, Vivek. And see, as Vivek explained, 4 P's: promise, picture, proof, push, and the structure of the article. Every article should have a title. If the article is of cooking, the title is let's take Sun Kitchen. The title is Sun Kitchen. Or your recipe name, and next introduction, and next body, and next conclusion, and next call to action. And these 5 are important structure for your article, and how to apply those 4 P's. and I will make clear again about 4 P's. Listen, you are going to promise, like, if you are going to use this product, or suppose your product is a drink. If your product is a drink, and that drink, if a consumer uses the drink, he can lose his weight, or he can lose 9 kgs in 30 days. And promise this in your title, that if you are going to use this drink, you are going to lose your weight of 9 kgs in just 30 days. And that should be your title, and your title should be attractive. That is a big promise you are going to make in the title. And even in the introduction, explain in detail about your promise. Explain that this drink is capable of making a person of 100 kg to 70 kg, like that. Just give some statistics and make some promises in title, and explain those promises in introduction. And next, in body, even body should be divided into some paragraphs, and you should not use the whole 600 to 700 words body into one paragraph. It might be clumsy, so just divide it. And next, make the audience to picturize the content while he is reading. Just start your body like this. Imagine yourself, you are drinking this drink by just making some basic exercises, so that you are going to lose 9 kgs. Then immediately the audience who is reading your content will imagine that he is going to lose weight, and he will imagine himself into a thin person. And next, after telling this picturization thing, and even the storytelling will be included in this. And next, after making him as a picture, after writing this, just give the proof. Proof is nothing but your article should explain about the drink, and your article should prove that your drink is capable of that. So mention the core product of your article is that this drink contains some some calcium, proteins, and these things and those things, some acids, so that while you drink this, this makes some changes with your fat, and this mix up in your blood, and it will automatically consume your fat. And you have to explain this so that the audience should convince. So audience should get convinced. Yeah, so that is the proof. And even in conclusion, you have to conclude that at last this is the product, and you should conclude it. And next, call to action. And now, call to action is used when you are going to sell your product. If it is not for selling, if it is just an article to be published, CTA will differ. And if you are going to sell a product, CTA will differ. For selling a product, you have to write call to action as, this offer is limited, and for now, this is 50% off, hurry up, buy it. And after reading all those promises, picture, proof, and all these things, audience will think that, and the product that you're selling should be of a minimal cost. Suppose your drink is 500 rupees, just make it 1000, strike off it and put it 500, 50% off. So the audience who is reading the prospect who is reading this content will definitely click on the link and will be redirected to the page, and he'll buy the product. So by using this promises, picture, proof, push formula, you can convert any audience, or not any audience, you can get up to 50% conversion rate. 100 people read, 50% will get converted. And for normal article writings, your call to action should be, for more articles like this, please subscribe this channel. And so we keep stay tuned like that. You have to use sentences like that for normal article writing, so that by reading your content, he will expect an article per week, so that they will visit our website again for the next week. So this is the importance of call to action, where you have to insert at last of the article. And this is called push. You are pushing it to the people's brain. Yeah, I think this is the structure of the article writing, and these are the things you are going to use, and just keep it in mind while writing the article. I think everybody understood. If no, you can ask your doubts now. If you have any doubt, please comment in the chat box. And there is a surprise that we are giving a chance to one of your intern to share her knowledge on keyword research, which is of next class. Her name is Meenakshi, and she is also a teacher of digital marketing. And as she has knowledge in keyword research as a digital marketer, we are going to give her a chance to speak in this webinar for tomorrow. And stay tuned to learn advanced keyword research training tomorrow. And she will be taking class for tomorrow, keyword research. And any of the audience are interested to teach in this webinar, if you have knowledge on some topic, any topic, just mention in the group so that we can think of that whether we have to add some extra classes so that you people get chance to speak here and get rid of the fear of teaching. Yeah. And guys, if you have any doubt, just ask now. Come on, we are waiting.
So guys, it is a question and answer sessions, and the last 10 minutes of the sessions, training sessions, is usually question and answers. If you have any doubts or queries, just mention it in the comment session. We are going to clear it out right now.
How to get ideas for writing blogs?
Great question. So generally, ideas are generated by choosing a specific niche. So choose your niche and research about your niche. You can definitely get awesome ideas. Generally, 4P is our formula. So we use the formula only for our clients.
For making sales, so we haven't used any article. We are just teaching this skill for you for free.
Copywriting.
Yeah. This is not used at any would you?
No, guys. Definitely, the promise should fulfill the product benefits. So definitely the product promise should be relevant to your product and your facts and factors.
Yeah, you will get this recording, sure.
Yeah, definitely you are going to get the recording of this session. Any more doubts? Thanks, Madhuri.
Hello, hello, hello.
Yeah, who is that?
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, Nadim.
I want to ask what the new activity has given by you. Nothing.
For this section is nothing. For the next section, you're gonna have a assignment.
Yeah, I'm going to tell one thing. Yeah.
You have not told who is best in the article content writing.
Sorry?
Content writing mein kaun, matlab aapne content padha rahega na, aapne bataya nahi ki kaun acha tha content mein.
Yeah. Yes, we have read all your content. In that manner, we have prepared this article. So, First, we regretted to explain you the 4P's concept, but this is needed for you to get improved well. And this 4P's concept is basically used for copywritings. And we are suggesting you to use this in article writing so that these articles will be improved. Okay. And we observe that so many people have, we asked for writing digital marketing, but one person have written about guerrilla marketing and all, and he just made a copy paste. And yeah,
so guys, one more thing, never ever do copy or steal someone's content, because there is a tool that is called plagiarism, which usually used to check whether the content is copied or not. So don't ever copy someone's content. And last time you have wrote an article about digital marketing, right? So here are the list of names of best of them. Parimal and Aman Kumar, Rupali, B. Jagadish, Dr. B. Jagadish, and Vaishnavi Penurkar, Vaishnavi. So Nandini and Sana Naz, Varun Garg, Ramya Sai, and Anuradha Kapoor. These are the 10 names which we have chosen best of them. And remaining we have reviewed, but most of them are copied. We have generally run through the plagiarism tool and we found many of them have copied the content. Remember these things, guys, never ever copy the content because Google hates the copied content. So keep that in mind. If you really want a serious career in content marketing or digital marketing, never ever steal someone's content. You can steal their ideas, but not their content. Remember this. Any more doubts? Thank you so much, guys.
Yeah, yes, copy from that is not okay.
Stay safe and stay healthy. And we are closing this session. Thank you so much for everyone for attending this session.
Thank you very much.
Hope you love the session and hope you love the session and please attend for the next session, which is based on advanced keyword research. Thank you.
Thank you.